We know that hurricanes and flooding are some of the most devastating natural disasters to impact communities. They impact people's lives, their homes, and the critical infrastructure that we rely on each and every day. But why is this important to think about? Well, it takes good preparedness. It takes a plan to understand how to respond to these events when they occur. More importantly, after they occur, recovery requires good insights to understand where to help a community get back on their feet as quick as possible. Now, I would say the one thing we have to our advantage is that both of these events, both hurricanes and flooding, have a little bit of a lead time to them. They're well known in the scientific community. The forecasting we get is phenomenal. It helps us understand when to expect the impacts. And when we couple that understanding with GIS, the technology that helps us understand the infrastructure, the people, and the environment we work in, we can start to really put this into motion to plan better for how to respond and ultimately to recover as quickly as possible. So what does this all mean for you? Well, if you're a GIS professional, there are a ton of ready-to-use data layers within inside of the Living Atlas of the World here at Esri. That means we can look at flood zones, we can look at forecasts for hurricane potential, and we can look at storm surge, for example, along a coastal community. But if you're not a GIS professional, there's also apps to help you. These are ready-made applications that bring this data to you, allow you to explore a community, to look at the demographics and the built environment, and to really start to understand the geographic extent of both of these phenomena. So let's take a look at what this actually means. My colleague Lisa Berry is going to show us a bit of this. She's a senior engineer here at Esri and an evangelist for the Living Atlas of the World. I think you're going to love what she has to show us. So Lisa, take us through the Living Atlas of the World and let's talk about hurricanes and flooding preparedness.
Thanks, Ryan. Before we dive into some of the Living Atlas resources, let's go back to the fundamentals of why we visualize data. Having an idea of where things happen really just gives us a foundational basis to understand data in a more easy to understand way. At the end of the day, everyone knows where they live, and so it gives them a basis to relate to what they're experiencing so communities can be more prepared and understand what's happening on the map.
What's absolutely true, Lisa. I love that connection between how data helps people understand, monitor changing conditions, and really act upon what they see to better prepare, respond, and recover all phases of an emergency as we look at it. You know, it's clear to me in my perspective of looking at how disaster response has played out around the world that GIS is making a difference. You know, a real example to me is Hurricanes Helene and Milton that hit the Southeast United States. It's what brought together on a map a common understanding between Transportation Department in North Carolina with the public safety officials doing emergency response and recovery missions. You know, 50 years ago, this would have been a paper-based product, sharing information through emails and maybe just changing documents. Today, it's real time, and it's using maps and GIS to really understand the dynamic situation. What does this mean? It helps them not only move people out of harm's way and forecast riverine conditions for flooding, it also is how they capture all the damage information to expedite recovery. This is about efficiency. The quicker that we can get people back in their homes or to recovery as quick as possible, the better the community and economic situation can recover as well.
That's an incredible example, Ryan. And what's amazing about that example is it uses a wide range of resources that are coming from what's called ArcGIS Living Atlas of the World. Now, Living Atlas contains ready-to-use spatial data and content that can be used in mapping projects like that one. For example, the hurricane information, that's coming from what's called our live feeds, which means it's live data coming in from the source. It also has live data that covered flood information or population information, and all of that is coming from Living Atlas. You know, there's so many different resources to build examples like this. So Florida did an example where they want the public to know their zone. And you can pull spatial information from Living Atlas like evacuation zones, flood zones, live flooding information, or even just what census tract do I live in? All that information can be pulled directly from Living Atlas into implementations like this, which can be applied to things like ArcGIS Hub, experience builders, and so many different other ways to communicate with the public. You know, and I would be remiss to not mention another set of content available in Living Atlas, which is our deep learning packages. Now, these are pre-trained deep learning models that can help you quickly answer questions before, during, and after a disaster. For example, before, you can figure out where all the power lines are so that you can detect where there might be potential for trees to fall on those during a disaster. Or after an event, you can use our deep learning packages that can help you detect structures to see where there might have been damage to those structures before and after to do a comparison. These types of deep learning models help you better understand and assess the situation when time is of the essence.
Absolutely love those examples, Lisa. It is such a great way to show the value of GIS helping people prepare, respond, and recover to disasters like hurricanes and floods. Now, what's exciting though is those are for GIS professionals. What about those people that don't have a GIS professional on staff or organizations that don't have GIS skills? You know, there are a ton of free available resources and ready-made applications inside of the Living Atlas to help as well. So Lisa, what if I was a person living at the coast in North Carolina and I'm looking at the forecast for the next hurricane and I want to understand what the storm surge or the flood potential might be for me and how I prepare? How can we help them as well?
You know, coastal communities really are some of the most at-risk areas in our country, but there's so many different resources to help you understand what's going on in those areas and understand the risks. We have sources from organizations like National Weather Service and FEMA to help you evaluate what's going on in your area. And beyond just that data, there's also apps like our Hurricane Aware that allow you to see live information as it's coming in to help you just visualize what's going on. Another example is if you're a city planner, you can use Living Atlas across the board to help you make your community more resilient. You can weatherproof your community by better understanding the risks that might face your infrastructure, like your roads. Flooded roads can cause major hazards, especially when there's evacuations that need to happen. And so if you weatherproof your town ahead of time, you're going to have a safer community and safer citizens.
Now, how about another scenario? What if I'm an outdoor enthusiast and I'm going camping or hiking in the outdoors? And I've never been there before and I don't really understand the flood potential. How can I be better prepared using the same type of applications?
We actually have multiple different resources for an example like this. One of them is our Live Stream Gauges app that helps you understand flooding as it's happening. And a lot of different National Weather Service forecasts are also included in Living Atlas to help you understand predictions of what's going to happen in, say, the next 72 hours. We also have a high tide app that helps you understand where there might be flooding anywhere up until 2100. So you can really look into the future and see where those risks might be happening as you plan your adventures.
If you're a GIS professional, I hope you take away that there is a ton of ready-made data available for you to include in your maps and applications now. It's hurricane preparedness time. It's always time to think about flooding and disasters. So take advantage of the Living Atlas of the world and add the data to your maps today. Get that better understanding. Now, if you're a non-GIS professional, I would encourage you to also go take a look at the freely available maps and applications that exist today inside of the Living Atlas. Lisa gave you a great example of how those can be put to action to understand your own community. You know, the Living Atlas of the world is for everyone. It's for GIS professionals. It's for non-GIS professionals. It's a way to bring geographic content to life and help us really understand the world we live in. Never a better time than now to prepare for the next hurricane or flood. So get started today.